Hi, I'm Belinda Carley, the Director of the Institute of Personal Care Science, and I often get asked, are natural cosmetics really safer? The short answer is not necessarily. And in this video, I want to go through a couple of examples to show you where natural cosmetics are in fact not safer than synthetic alternatives. At the end of the day, having a balanced approach to the materials that you use in your formula and checking their safety profile, regardless of whether they're natural or synthetic, is more important to the end consumer. And we should not be implying that synthetic materials are not safe simply because they're not natural, because natural ingredients aren't necessarily safe either. The first example I want to talk you through is natural soap. Now, the natural saponification process means that the finished soap product, whether it be liquid or in bar form, has a pH of at least 9.5. Usually, it's closer to a pH of 10. Now, regardless of what has been used to make that soap, the oils or extra glycerin, the point is that kind of a pH is not gentle on anyone's skin. What I find really interesting is that a lot of these natural soaps are marketed towards babies as being natural and safer for a baby, when in fact they're not, because a baby's skin is actually slightly more acidic than an adult's skin. So they should be using more synthetic detergent-based products, or they could be using naturally derived foaming agents that give a finished pH of around 5 to 5.5. That is much better for a baby's skin and human skin in general. So that would be the first example where natural doesn't mean safer. It's actually quite a lot harsher for the skin, especially sensitive skin types, babies and children. The next example I want to give you is essential oils. A lot of people assume that essential oils are safer than fragrances, and this is definitely not correct. When a perfumer puts together a fragrance, they know exactly what is going into that finished fragrance. They know the exact components and inputs that they're using, and they are very tightly regulated by IFRA. With essential oils, you have a lot of allergens present in those essential oils. You also have a lot of other natural active compounds present in essential oils. So using essential oils doesn't mean hypoallergenic, it definitely does not mean allergen-free, and it definitely does not mean safer than using a fragrance. In fact, a fragrance that's been put together by a perfumer is safer because they would have checked the compositional inputs of every single component to make sure it complies with the IFRA standards, which helps ensure consumer safety. So there would be another example where natural does not mean safer. Now, another one that consumers think is better for you is natural plant oils. Sure, natural plant oils often have a lot of omega or other fatty acids that are really good for the skin. They usually have a natural vitamin content, but they are usually quite comedogenic compared to silicones, for example. Now, silicone materials are non-comedogenic. They are definitely non-toxic. They are non-irritating. They are, in fact, very safe and mild for all of your skin types. Yet there's a lot of bad press about those materials, when in reality, silicones are non-comedogenic and very mild on skin. So this would be another example where the concept of being natural makes it safer isn't necessarily true. The natural plant oils and a lot of your natural waxes are more comedogenic on the skin than synthetic materials that may be used. And you can read more about this and actually review a journal topic by contacting us for information that accompanies this video. Another big misconception out there is that natural ingredients haven't been tested on animals. They certainly have. They've been tested on animals just as much as other synthetic materials. And again, please contact us and we can give you that information to support that statement. There are a lot of natural materials that inherently act as great food sources for microorganisms. So if they're not treated and stored properly, they can be ready growth sources for microorganisms, both when stored in a warehouse and when added to a finished personal care product. There's a lot of misinformation out there that would suggest that natural preservatives are safer than synthetic preservatives, and this isn't true either. you can have a look at sodium benzoate and potassium sorbate. They are actually quite irritating. The versions that get used in personal care also aren't natural. They're nature identical, which means they're exactly the same as they occur in nature, but they're produced using commercial sources. But the actual materials themselves are more irritating than a lot of synthetic preservatives out there. So again, a natural preservative doesn't necessarily mean it's safer than a synthetic offering. There are in fact a lot of synthetic preservatives that have had a lot of efficacy, irritancy and safety studies conducted on them to make sure they're safe when used in personal care products. When talking about preservatives in general, there are very strict regulatory limits over the use of preservatives in personal care to ensure consumer safety, whether they're natural or not. So this would be another example of where natural doesn't necessarily mean safer, and the product category itself, preservatives, is very tightly regulated to make sure that products and consumers are properly protected. Did you know that zinc oxide and titanium dioxide and even the iron oxides that get used in your mineral foundations are not actually natural? Sure, they get mined from the ground, but they go through a lot of purity and other processing steps to make them suitable to be used in personal care products. So all of these natural mineral foundations out there are actually using iron oxides that aren't completely natural. Your zinc oxide and titanium dioxide that get promoted as being natural sunscreen agents also aren't completely natural. But they do have some fantastic safety data behind their use. And of course, iron oxides give you a great natural color in your mineral foundations. But don't go around thinking they're completely natural, because they're not. And did you also know that natural clays mined from the ground need to be heavily treated to remove some very deadly organisms? Natural clays in particular need to be treated to remove deadly Clostridium species that naturally occur in the clay environment. So if they weren't treated in a certain way, they'd actually be very dangerous to be used in personal care products. Consumers in general tend to adopt natural substances into their lifestyle, thinking they're safer without ever really looking into the safety of these materials. They should be evaluated and tested the same way that we rigorously test synthetic materials. And yet synthetic materials that do come under significant scrutiny to make sure that they're safe for consumer use are often painted as being much more toxic or dangerous to consumers' health. It's simply not true. So about now, you might be wondering, where did all of this start? Well, it's not as simple as looking over that beautiful daisy field and thinking how wonderful it is to use these compounds from nature. Every single material that we use in personal care should be put under the same scrutiny, whether it's natural or synthetic. In fact, there's so many regulations out there today to make sure that consumers are only using products that contain safe ingredients. There is the EU technical guidelines that have just come out to help reduce some of this misinformation that exists. It's no longer okay to say paraben-free, sulfate-free, silicon-free, because there's nothing wrong with any of those ingredients when they're used as they should be, and with preservatives used within their regulatory limits. So it's incorrect to imply that there is harm from synthetic materials. It's incorrect to imply that natural ingredients are just safer than synthetic offerings, because the truth is, and hopefully by now watching this video you've seen some real examples, it's not necessarily the case. Does this mean we should stop questioning the safety of our products? Absolutely not. And it's a lot of these questions that have led to the regulations being developed that help ensure ongoing consumer safety. It's time for us to put natural and synthetic ingredients under the same scrutiny. Don't just assume it's safe because it's natural. Don't just assume it's bad for you because it's synthetic. There are thousands of fantastic materials in our industry, and using the best of natural and synthetic materials will help us create the best possible products for our consumers. There is no doubt that natural products continue to increase in popularity. Sure, there is the perception from consumers that natural means safer, but companies shouldn't be implying that. Natural materials are usually more sustainable, both in sourcing and reproducing. A lot of natural ingredients have natural nutrients occurring in them, which provide some benefits to the skin. And of course, that's a really easy story to communicate with your consumer. And using natural ingredients often gives back to remote communities, and it helps us ensure sustainable sourcing for our planet. So there's lots of benefits to using natural ingredients, and there's lots of sensory, stability, and performance benefits to using synthetic materials as well. Don't imply natural means safer. Don't imply synthetic means harmful. Use science to guide the best possible selections so you can deliver products that really exceed consumer performance expectations. Make sure you contact us if you want references for anything I've talked about in this video. The science is there to back it all up. Please give the video a thumbs up. Please leave any questions or comments below, and make sure you subscribe to receive notifications about all our videos. Happy formulating!